Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 23rd of 2019, well, it is titled Equinox, the Sun from Solstice to Solstice. So what do we see here? Well, we see multiple images of the sun taken on three different days of the year, showing how the position of the sun will change over the course of a year. During summer, at the summer solstice, the sun is highest in the sky. So that is the top band here. And during the summer and the summer solstice and during summertime, the sun is high in the sky and shining directly down on much of the earth. And it is also up above the horizon for longer than 12 hours. So it is up in the sky for a long time and shining down directly, and that heats us up and gives us summer. Now, the middle one here is actually from the vernal equinox, which would be the first day of spring. Today is the first day of fall, or the autumnal equinox, but the pattern for the sun that we see would be very similar. So here the sun is at a lower level in the sky, not quite as high, and it is up in the sky for exactly 12 hours. So on the day of the equinox, which would be today, the sun would rise and set 12 hours apart. Now, if you actually go and look up the times as to when the sun is rising and setting from your location, you'll find that today is not this day when things rise and set equally. The sun will rise a little earlier and will rise and set about 10 minutes apart, at least from my location. We have a sunrise at 6:55 in the morning and a sunset at 7:04. Now, why would this occur? Well, that's because when the sun is low in the sky, the atmosphere will refract its light and bring it up higher. So it'll make the sun appear higher in the sky than it actually is, making the sun rise a little earlier than it would if the Earth had no atmosphere, and set a little bit later. So it will actually be a couple days from now when day and night would be exactly equal because of the Earth's atmosphere. Had the Earth no atmosphere, then yes, today would be the day when day and night length are equal. Now we also see the bottom row here, much shorter than the other two. That is the winter solstice, the first day of winter, and when the sun is lowest in the sky. And it is also up for the shortest amount of time, giving us very cold days of winter. So we can see here how the sun's position varies: very high in the sky during the summertime, very low in the sky during the winter time. And the amount of time that it spends up above the horizon will also change drastically, being up in the sky for a long time during the summer and for a relatively short time during the winter. And this combination of two things gives us our seasons that occur here on the Earth. That is why summer is hot and winter is cold. One of the misconceptions that often comes up is that it has to do with the distance from the Earth to the sun. And yes, the distance between the Earth and the sun does change. We are in an elliptical orbit, meaning we are at a time closer to the sun by a small amount and further away from the sun by a small amount. However, that is a very small difference. And if you actually look, we are closest to the sun early in January and furthest from the sun in July. So that would go contrary to our expectations as to how we would be able to explain the seasons. In addition, looking at the distances would not be able to explain why the northern and southern hemisphere have opposite seasons. And it is all due to these two effects, which are ultimately caused by the tilt of the Earth's axis. So that was our picture of the day for September the 23rd of 2019. It was titled Equinox, the Sun from Solstice to Solstice. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Martian dunes thawing. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone. And I will see you in class.